Hello and welcome to this session from Business Technologies Limited. We are going to look at a common and reliable means of communication, which most companies and individuals use to communicate with their customers, receiving and sending emails. And in this era of coronavirus, this has been a reliable means of communication for most of us. And attackers can use this platform to also gather credentials and exploit companies and individuals. We are going to look at a platform called GoFish, which will help us to demonstrate a way in which an attacker can use emails to gather information if you are not careful. And so we are going to sign in as a user. As shown in this demo. Once you log into the GoFish interface, you can be able to track the emails that have been sent, those that have been opened, clicked, linked, and even submitted data from customers. So the first category is the sending profile, where the people sending the emails are indicated. Like you can see, this email will be sent from a bank. Most of the attackers spoof emails, spoof domains to send emails to victims. And so, as you can see, it's bankltd.co.ke. If you're not careful, you won't be quick to know that this email is not legitimate. And you can check at an email template that has been sent to the customer, as shown. And in this email, the customer is being asked to change their banking account details because someone accessed them and there is a link that has been attached to the email asking them to key in their username and their passwords. And now with GoFish, you'll be able to get all the data that will be submitted. So we are just going to launch a campaign for this demonstration and then send an email to the customer. Then we can see what will happen once we submit their data. So launching our campaign. The email has already been sent to the customer, as you can see. And once the customer opens that email, they'll be able to get some message.
So as an unsuspecting customer, I receive an email from my bank. So when I see it's like very much legitimate from the bank because of where it's coming from, I go ahead to open it. And when I read the information, somehow satisfied that it's from them because I'm not very much careful on checking into detail, I click on the link. Once I click, I see the page that is coming is from the bank's website. And when I'm prompted to enter my details, I am not very much careful on that. I decide to give the details and then log in, not knowing that I have given away access to my account.
So once we come back to GoFish, you should be able to see what the customer has done. And as you can see, the email has been opened and the customer has clicked on the link and even submitted their data. So what can we be able to do as an attacker? Using this data, we can be able to access other accounts like their social media accounts, your emails, in case you're using the same credentials. And you can also be able to see the version that has been used, for instance, Windows, which will guide you more in exploiting and guides the attackers in exploiting more and even exposing your companies to danger. So it's good to be careful once you receive an email. Don't be quick to click on links when you're not sure, or even download attachments. Be very careful, especially the emails that appear in the spam. Most of them are not legitimate and it's good to watch out.
So if you want our services, user training, phishing simulations, and more of cyber security services, visit at our social media platforms at Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, or our website at www.searchnets.com. Also, our social media name is Searchnets LTD. Be aware of phishing and Here at SearchNets, our main target is to ensure that you are cyber safe.
Thank you and see you next time.